Hi, I'm Simon Phillips from Drumeo, and I'm going to talk about playing rock tunes, or some advice which I'd like to offer. One piece of advice, never be afraid to play simply. I think the pump is an absolute wonderful example of that. There's so much tendency to want to play a fill when it doesn't need it. There's like, you can probably count them, there's probably three fills in the whole thing. There's a bit of a story about that because I tend to play fills a little differently to people, mainly in where they come. And the opening fill, which is those three hits on the gong drum, after that record came out and people had heard it, a guitarist named Bernie Marsden, who was in Whitesnake at the time, he said, excuse me for saying this, but did you make a mistake at that beginning fill just before the guitar comes in? I went, no. He said, because that fill's in the wrong place. I said, good. I'm glad you think that. It's in an interesting place. It's not what you would expect. You would expect one, two, three, four, ba-ba, right? But I played it like it was almost like a 3-4 bar. One, two, ba-ba, four, You know, I meant to play it. I never even thought about it until Bernie mentioned it. I went, oh, really? Is everybody gonna think that I messed that up? But no, that was, to me, the fill that was needed to set up the melody when Jeff comes in. Apart from that, it's all about groove, it's about touch, and it's about consistency, every backbeat being exactly the same. If you want to have a friend as an engineer in a studio, give him consistency, because that's really all they want. I'm speaking from an engineer. I know that's what I want when I put up some tracks. I want to see that kick and that snare drum bang on every time, especially the snare. Because the kick might be doing some other stuff, but that backbeat is so important, especially in rock and roll.
Now, I know you're all waiting to hear Simon talk about his work with Judas Priest, but before we do that, I just want to make sure you all know about Simon's brand new course inside of Drumeo called Elevate Your Drum Sound. Now, Simon's known for playing with bands like The Who, Jeff Beck, Toto, and many, many others, and he has some of the best drum sounds you will ever hear in your life. So if you want to learn more about how Simon actually gets those sounds on the drums, you can click the link right below this video to start a free 7-day trial to Drumeo, or there's a button right here on screen. And with that, let's dive into Dissident Aggressor by Judas Priest.
Now, Dissident Aggressor, wow. I don't remember how the band were going to play the tune. Remember, we didn't have demos in those days, or if we did, it was very, very simple. But when I heard that song, I went, ooh, I want to play a 6-8 in this, double bass drum. And it just worked. It worked great because it put a different spin on that track. Hey! yes, there's a lot more action going on. There's a pretty fast fill at the beginning of the song. One, two, three, four, five. I think I managed to use all six toms. Well, actually, I was doing this on an octoplus, so there were nine toms. A bit like this, I guess. How many have I got? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. it was always kind of a bit of a challenge, right? Let's see how many I can get in. But I managed to get six in. That was quite good. But it worked for the music. If it wasn't going to work for the music, I wouldn't have done it. When we're playing the groove, it's the consistency, that backbeat. You know, if you listen to the track, even though it was done a long time ago, there's still, you know, a good hit on every offbeat and hopefully a similar sound too. In those days, we didn't know, well, we couldn't sample in those days. It just wasn't an option. So we had to play it right. First time. One thing which I think is missing sometimes in understanding how to play rock, there's a tendency to play it all at one level. It's not really how it works. There are dynamics in rock, maybe not as much as there are in jazz or other types of music, but there are dynamics. The dynamics can be level. That's your normal understanding of dynamics. This bit is a little bit louder than this bit. Generally, when the singer sings, I tend to always come back a little bit in volume. I'm not giving up anything. I'm not giving up any groove. I'm not giving up any sound, but just a little bit to let the singer have some room. That's very, very important. Also, be mindful of when you're playing hi-hat, how open that needs to be. When there's a verse, close it down. Doesn't have to be hugely tight, super tight. It can be a little loose, but be mindful of all the different variations of how that hi-hat can be, you know? My rule of thumb is the verse would be a relatively tight hi-hat. The B section, I would open it a little bit more. And then the chorus, I usually go to the ride cymbal or the bell. That works pretty much in all situations. The other thing about dynamics is mainly what you play. Empty out the kick drum. It's not so much about volume, it's about mass, maybe, amount of notes. See how many beats you can get away with in terms of less as opposed to more. The same thing about when playing four on the kick. Try actually playing it as two on the kick. Just the downbeat. So one, two, three, four. That can actually sound bigger and more of a groove than playing four. If you really need to play four, everybody just feels that you do, then by all means, play four, but make sure when you play that snare drum, just to lighten up on that kick drum to make that snare speak. And you'll be amazed how it will feel. Generally, feel tends to go out the window the harder and stronger you play. If you're playing a take over and over again, and you're not quite getting it, you tend to start playing harder and harder and harder, and the groove goes out the window. Try the opposite. Try actually playing a bit quieter. You might find the feel will come all the way back.
So I hope you all enjoyed that lesson from Simon Phillips, and clearly Simon's drums sound incredible. So once again, Simon has a brand new course called Elevate Your Drum Sound, and you can check it out by clicking the link right below this video to get a free 7-day trial to Drumeo.